Hello everyone, welcome to the official YouTube channel of Hylia Institute of Technology. Please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for getting continuous notifications.
So let me introduce about our student, ex-student. Her name is Amrita Vishas. She's a 2014 graduate from HIIT Computer Science Engineering. She worked for almost 6 years in India right after her bachelor's. Then she pursued master's in computer science from Georgia University, USA, and currently working in a product based MNC, multinational company, there as a full stack engineer. So this is about our brief introduction. So over to Amrita, please you speak before the students so they can feel motivated, and you can revisit your old college, old department.
So sure, please, yeah,
please.
Definitely.
Over to you. So student, right. Listen carefully.
Good morning, everyone. I am Amrita, and TKG sir has already introduced me. So I don't take much of your time. It's quite late over here. Let me just give you a few examples of how this new age techs are impacting our future, our present. So I must say you guys are really lucky that you are having quite a lot of options to major in that we didn't have in our time. So something like AI, artificial intelligence, ML, cybersecurity, it's cool stuff, right? So AI is impacting the future virtually in every industry for every human being. So we are already seeing artificial intelligence in our smart devices, car, healthcare systems, and whatnot, right? Cars like Tesla, total autonomous car. I think, and I'm sure you all know about Tesla. And in healthcare, diseases are more quickly and accurately diagnosed nowadays. Drug discovery is sped up. And there is a concept called virtual nursing assistants, which monitor patients. And big data analysis helps to create a more personalized patient experience. These are all something which AI has already achieved. So just think about the perspective that AI is having in the field right now. Facebook, I'm sure you all are aware of Facebook, uses a DL application called DeepFace to teach it to recognize people in the photos that you upload. I'm sure you have seen that when you upload a photo, the person in the photo gets automatically detected, right? Facebook also uses something called deep neural networks. It helps to decide what advertisements to be shown to which users. Coming to cybersecurity, it does matter because it has impact that is beyond the digital world and into the physical one, right? So there was this company called Equifax, which was hacked, and 145 million Americans were impacted. Just think about how terrifying it might be. So cybersecurity is becoming critical with every passing day. As breach after breach hits headlines, it's clear to everyone, right, that organizations need more professionals focused on cybersecurity. So coming to my experience, I have worked on a couple of very interesting projects during my MS tenure. One was to study the worm propagation in a live network, basically creating a worm which will replicate in a network and try to study the pattern of how a worm behaves in real time. And this project was one of its first kind. And another one I remember, which was really interesting one, was about spreading honeypots in our network. Now, typically honeypot is nothing but a trap to lure malicious user into your own network. Now you must be thinking, why would anybody do that, right? So what we did was we designed a virtual camera as a honeypot and exposed it to the outer world. So if anyone tries to access it, they will see a video running, thinking it as a real exposed camera. But actually, in turn, we are logging all the activities that the user is trying to do while inside our network. So we created a dashboard using Kibana and Elasticsearch. We used ML algorithms to study the behavior of any real-time hacker. This is pretty cool, I think. So I think you guys can imagine how machine learning, AI, or cybersecurity together is impacting our future, and it is becoming the next big thing. It can automatically detect and analyze security incidents. Some can even automatically respond to threats. So this was my experience with this new cutting edge tech, and I hope this gives you an idea how the real world is getting impacted right now. So apart from studies, do enjoy your college life, of course. Go to your professors and they will be there and really happy to help you even after college. I'm pretty sure about that. So you guys are in good and safe hands. Try to explore your college life and your professors to the utmost. And that's that. If you have any questions, you can shoot.
Ma'am, what about data science?
Yeah, of course, data science is a big thing, right? Everything is data. Although I don't have a personal experience dealing with data science stuff, to be honest, but just think about it. Anything, we are talking here right now, so it's data. Anything is data. So analyzing data, reaching to a pattern, studying it, it's under data science. And of course, ML is involved everywhere.
Ma'am, could you guide us?
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
How should we start the journey as a computer science cybersecurity guy from the first year to attain a very good career in future? What you would have done if you would again get a choice like that?
Well, I will always increase my analytical skill. That's the important thing to do.
Good morning, senior. My question is, from which year we have to start trying for internship?
To be honest, I never did internship in my bachelor.
Okay. I am from CS AI and ML. So my second question is, do we really need to attend a coding competition?
I'll say it's totally onto you. I still attend coding competitions because I like it. So if you don't like it, you don't have to. You don't have to prove to anybody that you can code. You just need to learn by yourself. That's it.
No, actually, I like it. But I have no any rough idea about from which year I actually need to put my head on it.
Right now. You need to start right now.
Okay. Thank you, senior. Ma'am, my question is to the senior. Which language I need to practice for competitive programming?
Well, I'll suggest learn as much as you can. So if you ask me, I know JavaScript, React, Java, advanced Java, Python, and I forgot a few more, to be honest. So start learning whatever you're comfortable in. I'm pretty sure our professors will be more than happy to help you.
I question senior that when we have to work upon algorithm and data structure from which year onwards?
Year that you should start learning it from, start learning it right now. There's no end to data structures. There's no end to algorithms. There are a hell lot of algorithms out there. You can't even add them right now. So start learning from right now. Grasp everything that you can.
Okay, thank you, seniors.
Yes, ma'am. I asked you about which certificate course for a cybersecurity guy and how much this atmosphere will change in upcoming 4 to 5 years and how much you should study for cybersecurity to get as much as internship and a good career, a job in an upcoming future.
Well, it depends. If certifications are always there to help you, but at the end, it's about your analytical skills, your logical skills that you will land on a job with, right? So right now, I do not have any certifications on my name, to be honest. So it's totally up to
Thank you.
If you're interested, go out.
Which language should we study for our future, which would help us in future?
Take a note, guys. So there is no specific language that will help you boost up your career. So if you are aiming for job market, So companies do not look what exact language you know. They just look for your logical and your analytical skill. If you are able to code in any language, given any language, you will be able to code in Python or Java. It's just the syntax that differs, right?
Okay. Thank you.
So if you see most of the projects in Microsoft, they work in C++. But where I work, most of the thing is done in advanced Java or Python. So it doesn't really matter. I never knew Python before joining my company right now. And see me, I'm working with Apache Beam in Python right now. So it really doesn't matter.
Okay, thank you.
Frankly speaking, we have been very lucky to have you throughout the session. But considering your state, I really feel very bad. And so I think that we will have to, because of this time constraint, we will have to stop this question and answer session now.
Well, I must say, I am lucky to have HID as my alumni matter, right? As my alma mater.
Thank you so much, Amrita.
Best, and we really feel proud of you also at the same time.
Oh, thank you so much. This made my day. I mean, made my night, maybe. So just before going off, guys, I'll say respect your teachers. That's utmost of importance. Do not bunk your classes. Do make memories and do use your exploit your professors to the most. They are your guiding force. So all the best to you for your future. Bye-bye. And you can always contact me through LinkedIn. You can connect with me.